You know, it feels good, but, you know, honestly, playing inside, I got to learn a lot. I think it's helped me step my game up as far as, like, being more physical and whatnot.
What was the biggest adjustment you made from last year in JUCO ball in Canada and Wyoming to Tennessee? What was the biggest difference?
I think it was all just a learning experience. You know, there was times last year where it was really tough for me. But I think one thing I learned was just, like, perseverance, just to persevere and keep working hard.
What can you tell us about today's circle of life? It looked like you got put up against Trey Smith. He's a freshman. What have you seen out of him so far, and what is that drill like going against a guy that big?
You know, Trey Smith was very impressive. He came in here, just put his head down, kept working. I got a lot of respect for him, and, you know, every day we push each other to get better. So, you know, there's times he gets me, there's times I get him. So, you know, it's just a good competition.
What about expectations when you come in as the number one JUCO guy? I mean, do you feel that pressure? Do you know that everyone was expecting just huge fireworks right out of the gate?
I mean, so going into last year, I let it get to me too much, like the pressure and what everyone expected. So definitely it was something on my mind coming in. I feel like a difference coming in from this year. I'm not really paying attention to all that. You know, I had a good year behind great DNs like Derek Barnett, Corey Vereen. I think that's really helped me step my game up. So, you know, this time around, I'm just putting my head down and working.
How much of an opportunity do you feel like there is? You know, with Cam gone now, just how much of a need is there for someone like you to step forward and have a good year this year?
Pretty much with Cam gone, Cam still comes around a lot. He still helps whenever anybody at the DBs need help. We can go talk to him anytime. He's like a big brother to everybody. So I just feel like basically that it's not no big rush to step in and take his place, but when it happens, it happens.
Do you notice Coach Jones just being, we all know a big deal out of the fact he's less talkative on the mic, but do you sense he's looser now than maybe in years past?
Because Jones, he's starting to relax a lot. And then, you know, the team takes the vibe of their head coach because that's just how it is. So Coach Jones is starting to get looser, starting to relax a little bit more, and I feel like that's just opening everybody up.
What would you say about that focus, Justin? One of the things that Coach Shoup told us earlier this year was no drama off the field. You know, how is that adjustment? What have you guys done to make sure that there's no drama off the field?
Communication is a major key. That goes for everybody. You don't ever want to. It was a lot of behind-the-scenes drama with people not communicating. And you don't ever want to just hold stuff in, because when you hold it in, eventually you explode, and that's never good. So I feel like a big piece is communication, everybody getting around each other. If a problem occurs, we address the situation immediately and then move on about our business.
Last year, you said that John Kelly isn't a wait-my-turn kind of guy. He's a I-want-to-go-play-right-now kind of guy. Do you feel like because of that mentality, he's adjusted naturally to his new role?
Absolutely, absolutely. You know, John's never been a I'm-going-to-wait, you know, coach kind of guy. You know, he's always been ready to go. And, you know, right now, he's taking the run with it. You know, even in bowl prep, I think he understood that bowl prep is like his time to go. And you know, even though Alvin was there for the Nebraska game, I think you can start to see John Kelly saying, this is going to be my running back room. And Alvin being the guy he is, understood that, you know. So he's been great, man. He's been great attitude. He's been fighting through some little dings and bruises because he understands that's what this team needs to see. You know, they need to see, you know, being a leader is also leading when you're not feeling good every day. So I think that's another thing he's been doing so far, just fighting through some injuries and some things that he's not feeling good. He's out there every day working his ass off.
What goes through your mind when you see Alvin Kamara out here working out in Indianapolis and rocketing up draft boards all over seemingly?
Excited for him. You know, I mean, it shows that if you just work your butt off and it's the team goals come first, you're a great teammate, anything can happen for you. So I'm excited for him. Everything he has, he deserves. He's had a long road to get here, and I'm excited. Me and my wife, my family, we're all excited for everything that Alvin's doing right now. His best football is going to be ahead of him.
The last couple of years, you've kind of had two guys in the back, and that two running backs kind of being able to share the load. Are you looking at John kind of being the main guy next year, or is there somebody who's kind of shaped up as that 1A or maybe?
Well, before Alvin got here, it was only one guy. You know, Alvin and John Kelly
right,
came in the same
two,
class.
The last two seasons.
Yeah, well, you have to recreate yourself. And that's what mm-hmm. we are again. We go out and recruit. I think Ty Chandler's a hell of a football player. He's going to come in here and be ready to play. Trey Coleman. You know, this is my first time being able to say those guys' names. I think Trey Coleman, Todd Chandler, and Tim Jordan, those guys are going to come in and be ready to play. We meet and we talk football almost every day. So the same install, this practice that these guys just did, we're going to go and watch that with those guys tonight. You know, technology is something special. You know, Skype and all that stuff. So those guys will know the offense and be ready to come in and play. It's just recreating yourself. That's the SEC.
Just the offensive line's attitude. I mean, just watching your guys in that drill in general, it seems like there's a different attitude, edge about them maybe?
Well, I think they want to prove that they are, you know, who they are. And they want to dominate at the line of scrimmage. And that's something that we preach every day. And it's something that is a tradition around here and we've got to continue to uphold. I mean, there's been a lot of great offensive linemen at the University of Tennessee. And to continue to educate them on that and continue to try to draw that out of them. You know, most of your good football teams are good up front, and we've got to be good up front.
Do you think Trey is trending toward thinking less and playing more as spring goes on?
There's no question. The problem is Bob puts more stuff in. So as we do that and as we put more in, he takes a step back for a half of practice and then figures it out, just like any guy that should be getting ready for, you know, the prom and graduation and everything like that. But Trey, nobody's going to outwork Trey. He works hard, and he comes in and does the extra things.
Coach, Drew really finished on a high note last year. Has he picked that up this last season spring?
Yes, he is. He's had a good spring also. And you know, I didn't really consider him one of the younger guys when we were talking, but Drew's done a nice job. And where Drew is really picking up is the mental aspect of understanding what the defense is trying to do to him, and then his physicality in the run game. He's starting to come around on that side.
Where do you like this unit is under you through 3 weeks, and where do you feel like you want to see a little bit better?
I would like, you know, I think physically they're doing some of the things we want them to do. I think they're coming together as a unit, and I think they're coming off the ball fairly well. What I'd like to see improve is the communication aspect and the overall understanding of everything that we're trying to get done, and then be able to communicate, set things, change things at the line of scrimmage, on the move, and then be able to come off the football and do it well.